Hello, today I'm going to show you how to create this collage. Let's open a new document, set the stroke to none, and use any color for the fill. Now select the rectangle tool and draw a square to cover the artboard. Next, go to Object, Path, and select Split into Grid. Turn on the preview box. Set the number of rows and columns to 3 and the gutter to 12. When we open layer 1, you will notice 9 new shapes. Switch to the selection tool and click away to deselect. Next, we will select only the shapes that we would like our photo to show through. Click on one of the squares to select it. The blue square indicates the selected shape. Next, hold down the Shift key and select more squares. And here are all the shapes that we have selected. Now press the Ctrl and G keys on your keyboard to group them together. Before we can place our photo over a group of shapes, first we need to create a compound path. To do this, we can either press the Ctrl and 8 keys on our keyboard or go to Object, Compound Path and choose Make. Now make sure that the Compound Path layer is selected and then click on the Draw Inside icon. Now go to File, Place, find your photo and click Place. Click, hold and drag your image over the artboard. Let's open this new clip group layer. You will notice a compound clipping path and a linked photo file. With the photo selected, we can reposition it or scale it. If we wish to change our photo, first select the linked image file from the tab toolbar and then choose Relink. Now select a different photo and click Place. I'm going to leave mine as it is. Let's lock this clip group to prevent it from shifting. I'm going to change the color of the remaining squares to green and red. Next, we will place letters. First, select the Type tool. We can either use the Type tool or the Vertical Type tool. It doesn't matter. Now click and type. Highlight the text and let's change the color to white. Next, switch to the Selection tool, then right-click and choose Create Outlines. Right-click again and choose Ungroup. Now we can move each letter individually. Next, we will place the first letter in the exact center of the top green shape. To do this, first select the green shape and then, while you are holding down the Shift key, select the letter L as well. Now click on the green shape to mark it as a key object. You will notice a heavy blue border around it. Next, open the Align panel and select Horizontal and Vertical Align Center. And let's do the same with the other letters and squares. We could also use a graphic symbol, for example. If you would like to learn how to create this ornament, please check out my other tutorial. I've included a link to it in the description below. And like we did before, select the ornament and the square. Mark the square as the key object. And align everything to the center. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.